Let us discuss working and applications of a venturimeter. A venturimeter is a device. You can also write down that venturimeter is a device used to measure flow velocity of liquids in pipelines or in tubes. Here you can see this is the picture of a typical venturimeter. In this system of venturimeter, you can see there is a pipe. At one end of the pipe is connected to a constriction where its cross-sectional area is reduced. Say, the pipe in which the fluid is flowing is having a cross-sectional area A1 and it is connected to a narrow constriction where a cross-sectional area is A2. Then obviously if the flow velocity of liquid and pipe is V1, in the constriction its flow velocity changes to V2. And by continuity equation we can write that A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2. And we can also state as velocity is increased due to less cross-sectional area, the pressure will also decrease, which we already studied in the topic of pressure-velocity trade-off. That if flow velocity increases at a horizontal level, the pressure will decrease. To measure the pressure in pipe as well as in constriction, two tubes are connected. One is at the level of constriction and other is at the level of pipe. And these two tubes we term as pressure tubes, because these tubes are used to measure the pressure difference. As in pipe pressure is relatively more, the liquid level which is raised in the pressure tube above the pipe is more, and in constriction if the pressure is less because of higher velocity, the liquid level will be raised to a lower value. And the level difference H can be easily measured by the scale which is described on the tubes also. And in this situation, by using Bernoulli's theorem at these points, say this point is A and this point is taken as B, which are on the same horizontal level, we can apply Bernoulli's theorem and we can write that using Bernoulli's theorem at points A and B, here we'll be getting at point A the kinetic energy of liquid particles per unit volume will be half rho V2 square, plus here pressure can be written as PA, and this must be equals to at point B we can write half rho V1 square plus PB. And in this situation we can write half rho V2 square minus V1 square is equals to PB minus PA. And the pressure difference can directly be written as H rho G, because this pressure is responsible for rise in level of liquid in pressure tubes. And if the difference is H, then pressure at point B and A is due to this extra H height of liquid column. Here rho gets cancelled out, and we can also substitute the value of V2 from here. V2 can be given as V1 multiplied by A1 by A2. If we substitute the value of V2 here, this will give us half V1 square. This will be A1 square by A2 square minus 1 is equals to Hg. And from this expression, we'll get the value of V1. That is the flow velocity of liquid in pipeline, which is given as root of 2gh divided by A1 square by A2 square minus 1. This is quite a useful expression you should always keep in mind, which is giving us directly the flow velocity of liquid and pipelines through which a venturimeter is connected. The only thing which we need to measure is the difference in liquid level in the two pressure tubes, as well as the cross-sectional area of a pipe and that of constriction. This is giving us the result of flow velocity of liquid.